Hey guys, I'm LB. We are back playing the Talos Principle Road to Gehenna DLC. No, wait, what? No, we're not playing Road to Gehenna DLC, we're playing user-created content. It's been a long time since I've said that. This is the second episode. I know it says episode 1, but the first episode was episode 0, so if you're looking for the first episode, you need to find episode 0. Triangular Inhibition. I just realized something. Let me stop. Because the last map we were playing had really dumb music that I couldn't play. But this map... Let me go to sound options. Okay, so we can let the game's natural music play now, since this map doesn't use dumb music. I kind of forgot about that. So, we were in triangular- oops, come on. Triangular Inhibition. And in Triangular Inhibition, what I think we want to do is get a rotation or alternation of the lasers. So we want it so that... So that this field and this field are off, and then after a while it switches so that this field is off. That seems to be the theme of the entire map so far, at least all the puzzles I've played have been that way. And the thing is, we gotta figure it out. It's a... laser puzzle, thick laser puzzle, because of the lasers, how they, like, let me show you. Has to do with this right here, the fact that the laser beams can't cross. Oops, nope, don't do that. Nope, nope, nope. Maybe? Oh, okay, that worked. That was actually much simpler than I expected it to be. So we don't actually have to cross the lasers at all, that's interesting. Alright. So, to get the keys... We need both red and blue. That's interesting. Okay, so this is much easier than I expected, so it's not at all about crossing the beams. In fact, we don't want the beams to cross, apparently. Oh wow, that was really straightforward. You just go in a circle, basically. Yeah, you literally just go in a circle. Holy crap. Why didn't I try that first? Okay, let's stop doing that, please. And let's figure out how to do... this nonsense. That's gonna be a bit of an issue. Because we can get that. But now the question is, how do we get blue? Tight window. I have an idea. These guys start up on top, right? So... let's see here, we want... sorry, see asbestos. Alright. We want this one. Aha! So, if we make like before... and then... for this guy... oh wait... that's an issue. I did not think that through, I thought we had four. Is there an eagle's nest nearby, perhaps? I'm not seeing one. I mean, another option is to try... no, but there's no... there's no way we can make an angle like that. Yeah, we can't get a laser from another puzzle. Oh, and this wouldn't even have worked the way I was expecting it to. Look at that. Oh man, that's unfortunate. I mean, could have worked. Kinda, not really. Oh well, let's just, alright, what the heck did I do that for? I don't think there's a source or target up there. I want these keys! Definitely can't point at both at once. Thank you. that's basically the best we can do. That. And then... yeah, it doesn't get us a good angle for that. Oh, that's interesting. The beams don't collide because these are high enough. There's no way we can just walk along up there. That would definitely be against the... that would, like, be a huge exploit in the puzzle. Stuff can't go through the bars, right? Yeah. I don't know, I don't really see how to do this one right now. I guess we'll come back to it some other time. 2 plus 2? Oh dear. No, I just remembered there's a fast forward button in the options that I never used in the main game or the DLC. Fast forward. What would I want that to? Is there anything on control? Okay, so this does do what I thought it did. Okay. It also means the audio, unfortunately. So, we can fast forward while recording, which is nice. I think this also just applies to, in general, oh, why did I do that? Why did I do that? But yeah. So, this is sprinting, and then this is holding control. Whee! And apparently I've heard that this is banned in speedruns, so... Alright. It's mainly- oops. And then we do this. And then we- oops, we do this. And we just fast-forward through the whole thing. And this should be good enough. There's that, right? Okay, so I think I did this all fine. I didn't need that much time, because... yeah, even if I get in here, as long as I get the jammer out, I'm not trapped. So here's the thing, is there a way to select the further guy? 'Cause that would really help. First of all, I wanna know what this deactivates exactly. So let's do that. This. That's unfortunate. That's exactly what I thought it did. Ooh, I think we may be onto something there. Yes, I think that may have done it. Yes, I think that's all we needed to do. This. And yeah, okay, that was simpler than I thought. Alright, well guys, as always, thank you for watching. If you hate the sound of my voice, leave a dislike, it's up to you. And I will see you all for the next episode. Goodbye.